Hello everyone. So recently I built this little, it's a bowed lyre. It's kind of like a tagelharpa or a jouhikko. It's kind of my own take on it. It's got three strings. These are fishing line, 4 pound fishing line that has been wound. In this case, I've got 16, 20, and 24 strands of very fine fishing line. It's almost as thin as horsehair, which is what I was going for. Anyhow, on the body of it itself, it's got these otters cut into it. I did that on the scroll saw, as well as these slots, which help the top ring more freely. There's a sound post. There's a sound post inside, and these little holes drilled around it. And this is to, again, to help it ring freely. The soundboard is made out of 1/8 inch Baltic birch plywood. The body of it, in terms of the frame, is made of Douglas fir, and the soundpost is made of birch, and the bridge is made of oak. This tailpiece is just a piece of aluminum that I bent into like a kind of a U shape, and so far it's holding up pretty well. The tuning heads are just standard guitar style tuning heads. I experimented around with several kinds of string. At first I was using the 100 pound as monofilament, and that didn't work very well. There's a lot of screeching and stuff. So I then took it and I made twisted pairs and triplets, and sounded better, but it still had a lot of issues pertaining to how the bow hits different strands of it and induces different overtones. So I went out and I got, you know, many, many different kinds of this fishing line. You know, 4 pound, 20 pound, 10 pound. And I found that the 4 pound stuff, when I use lots of strands of it, works the best because it's essentially the same thickness as horsehair. So that's what I did. I know I have horsehair, and I've also tried a horsehair string on it, but I found it too quiet and dusty sounding. And you know, it's kind of a pain to make that. To make these nylon strings, I made this jig that has these little metal pins on each end, and I wind it around, and this thing is a little over twice the length that I need the strings to be, and I'll wind them around half the number of strands that I want. And then I'll fold, I'll take the ends, I'll tape them, and I fold them, and I loop it through the, I'll loop it through the tailpiece, so I don't have to tie any knots there, because fishing line likes to slip. So, and then I go up here and I just twist it, then I chop the loop ends off, I feed it through the tuning heads, and I just turn it up, and so far it works well, and it's quite a bit like the horsehair strings. Anyhow, I hope you liked this video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and definitely stay tuned for updates. Until next time, thanks for watching.